This is Jazz Casual, and I'm Ralph Gleason. You've been listening to the John Coltrane Quartet, playing a composition by Mongo Santa Maria called Afro Blue. John Coltrane, like many of the modern jazz musicians, feels that the music itself speaks far more fluently than any human ever could. I agree with that thoroughly, and I also endorse the position of Miles Davis that albums shouldn't have liner notes, even when I write them. The thing that a modern jazz musician does, and which you should really keep in mind when you see him in concerts or see him in jazz clubs, is somewhat similar to looking at a poet standing in the middle of a supermarket and improvising poetry. They are called upon by the discipline of this art form to go into public places where people are gathered informally and to spontaneously create music. Unlike a poet, unlike a writer of a novel, unlike a painter, they have no opportunity to take this product that they have created and reform it and correct the mistakes that they might have made or change the way in which they approach it. What they do is done for all time right then when they do it. This is a very unique thing about jazz, and it's one of the things that gives it a particular quality of aliveness that makes it one of the most interesting and vital of all contemporary art forms. The first composition, as I said, was by Mongo Santa Maria. It was in 3/4 time. Many jazz musicians love to improvise in that time. We're going to have two compositions now, two original compositions by John Coltrane. On the first, he played the soprano saxophone. On these, he'll play the tenor. One of them is called Alabama, which he wrote fairly recently. The other is called Impressions. These are both compositions by John Coltrane. Be played for you by the John Coltrane Quartet. Thank you.
This is NET, National Educational Television.